slip away and my karma come to pay. I might just wake up someday and see the bit part that I play. But when the day is all through, nothing more that I can do. One thing I have learned is true, I turn, and there it's always you.
You lift the world from my shoulders, spin it gently, turn it over. You set it down out of the way,
just like a dream, the world fades away.
Just like a dream, the world fades away.
I may travel near and far, sail the seas to Zanzibar. I might just walk out the door and be content in my backyard. But when the miles are said and done, when the races are all run, I meet you in the setting sun. From there, we walk as one.
You lift the world from my shoulders, spin it gently, turn it over. You set it down out of the way,
just like a dream, the world fades away.
Just like a dream, the world fades away.
Trials may come to torment me, break right in without a key. They may all demand to be my eternal destiny. But when the worries and the cares get too much for me to bear, you look each one in the eyes just like that. You cut them down to size.
You lift the world from my shoulders, spin it gently, turn it over. You set it down out of the way,
just like a dream, the world fades away.
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 Across the United States, from Talkeetna, Alaska, to West Palm Beach, Florida, you are listening to River City Folk, a weekly broadcast of live performance, musical influences, and interview. I'm your host, Tom May. My guests this week at Cafe Artichoke in Portland, Oregon. Are my dear friends and the longtime duo Curtis and Loretta from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Long drive across the United States at $5 a gallon these days, and we are so glad to have them here. Thank you for coming all the way to perform for us. The song you just played for us, Lift the World, it's kind of indicative of the style of song you do. You incorporate a lot of Celtic influences into your songs, but you also tend to gravitate towards messages that mean something and resonate with making the world a better place, which is one of the reasons I've always loved your music so much. Is that an intentional thematic element that you visit?
Yes, absolutely.
You know, it just seems like the world could be a better place, all, you know, so we thought, yeah, we could say that.
Absolutely, yeah. That got to have a message, yeah. I hate those crying in your beer kind of songs. It's never took to those, so
yeah.
You've spent a whole life chronicling people's lives in small towns and trying to lift people's spirits by songs like that. But you began doing this more than 40 years ago. I know that for a while you both picked fruit in the orchards of the Pacific Northwest and lived kind of a nomadic existence. But music has been your life this entire time. Since then, you've managed to play and support yourselves and reach folks through these songs. So what an adventure it's been, huh?
Oh, yeah.
It has.
Yeah, just like your book, yep.
Yeah, it has, yeah.
And we explained it, yeah.
Yeah, and our goal was always just to play music full-time, but we had some, you know, part-time jobs along the way.
Determination and perseverance.
Yeah, we were like our own patrons of the art, just subsidizing our music career. But now for many, many years, we've done music full-time.
We're going to hear a song right now by two folks who are really well known in the midsection of the country, but not so well known here in the Pacific Northwest, perhaps. But Bill Hinckley and Judy Larson have been, were a duo forever. Bill has left us, but Judy is still performing and singing. And their songs were very important through the 1960s, through the whole Dylan, Minnesota era. And this song we're going to hear right now is called Western Borders. What about this song brings you back to listening to Bill and Judy?
Yeah, you know, Bill and Judy were just staples, you know, so inspiring to the whole music scene. They went to school with Garrison Keillor to college, you know, and they were all friends. And this song is just a beautiful song. It's written by our friend John Van Orman, which was another really important Minnesota folk musician. So I think you'll enjoy it. And Bill and Judy inspired us. You know, so many people inspire, musicians inspire each other. We need this inspiration just to keep going on, you know. You know, you see somebody play that you know, you realize you have to keep going. So, and these guys did it. It's a beautiful song. I think you'll like it.
The western borders of Minnesota have beds of granite.
In a bright, sunny Florida home, Christy was online and she was there alone. A Minnesota girl caught her eye. Usually, she'd scroll on by. Sick kids were too sad. Was it an angel that said don't pass? Ariana smiled at her. I'm 2 years old and need a kidney donor. Dialysis and 7 weeks old. You might be my hero. Is your blood type O? Christy said yes and picked up the phone. And she said, when there's good to be done, you must do it. You gotta wait for someone else to get to it. I knew it was God's plan and see me through it. How could I say no? When I could do it. She told her husband about the girl. If she was a Sarah, we would search the world. A battery of tests were begun. Up north for final ones. 6 months since that day. You're the perfect match, they called to say. She got back on that online page, sent a message to the mom, and she did say, I'm Christy, I'm honored to meet you. I have a 2-year-old too. Your girl's donor. And the mother could not find words. Christy said, when there's good to be done, you must do it. You gotta wait for someone else to get to it. I knew it was God's plan and see me through it. How could I say no when I could do it? Christy woke up and she was feeling pain. The very first thing she did say is, Ariana, okay? She gave life that day, and the purest joy was Christy's pay. And she said, when there's good to be done, you must do it. You can't wait for someone else to get to it. I knew it was God's plan, it see me through it. How could I say no when I could do it? When there's good to be done, we must do it.
When there's good to be done, we must do it.
We heard two pieces of music on River City Folk, Minnesota legends Bill Hinckley and Judy Larson with their song Western Borders. They were followed by my guests today, likewise from the Twin Cities, from Minneapolis, St. Paul, depending on when you catch them. You can catch them on either side of the river there. And this is Curtis and Loretta with the song that was a title cut from one of their CDs called When There's Good to Be Done. I was always just so very moved by that song, because the only reason I've stayed in folk music for 50 years is because I have this idea that it might make a difference to some people in a positive way. And certainly that song has been that, has been an idea in people's mind that they too can affect the world through what they do and through what they believe in. Curtis, you said you had a specific...
Well, I'll start the ball rolling. Now, this album was all... biographical ballads. I mean, and Loretta wrote the songs, and we, or she, would actually go and interview people, you know, and then go back and write the song and then play the song for them. Now, this was about a lady who obviously, as the song says, donated a kidney to a little girl that she'd never met before.
Yeah, I heard about her on the news in Minneapolis. I was sitting at home and heard this lady was flying up from Jacksonville, Florida to donate a kidney to a little girl she had found online. And so I waited a while, and then I contacted her and said, you know, we're going to be in Florida. Can I come and interview you and write a song? And she said yes.
Well, at first she was apprehensive about it. She said, you know, she was on the national news, and she said, this is something I just did spontaneously from my heart, and I don't really know if I want any more, you know, publicity about it. She said, you know, besides what, you think you write this song is going to inspire people to donate organs to people they don't know, you know? She said, well, he said, well, probably not. And she said, well, maybe it'll remind them to check that little box on their driver's license form.
The donor box.
The donor box, indeed.
But then we do have a great follow-up. We were up in northern Minnesota a couple years ago playing on a radio station, WTIP, in Grand Marais, Minnesota. And we played that song. And several months later, the program director sent us an email and said, do you remember that night you were here, played that song about the kidney donor? And a man from another town, Lutzen, had listened that night. And he was so inspired, he wanted to donate a kidney to somebody. And he didn't know a stranger to donate a kidney to. So he called a hospital. Of course, they matched him up. I love this part too. They matched him up with someone in California. And that person in California had a donor, but it didn't quite work out. So that person donated to someone else. It started this whole chain. And I love those connections. We feel so honored just to be the messenger.
So occasionally, yeah, if you keep writing these songs, sometimes some good gets done, you know?
Yeah.
We're just so when we say music that makes a difference on River City Folk, we're not just whistling Dixie. Thanks to Curtis and Loretta so very much for that song. You've got another recording for us to hear right now, and this is a recording by somebody that we all on stage knew. You both knew him very well. I knew him not as well, but he was a songwriter from the Twin Cities, good friend of Bill Staines. They were together when Bill wrote the song Roseville Fair. And Jerry was a guest on the program and came to performances I did there in Minneapolis. He was just one of these people. You felt peaceful when you were around Jerry, which is interesting because he was in Vietnam. He was a Marine, but he went on to do work to try to alleviate the violence of that period of time. So I'll let you talk a little bit more about
Jerry was a good friend of ours, and I have to say he was so inspiring to us. There's a little place we played in Minneapolis at the New Riverside Cafe, and we'd heard of Jerry Rao. And we were playing there one night, and we looked at Curtis, and there he is in the audience. I said, "That's Jerry Rao listening to us."
One of the early, the Minnesota Minstrel.
They called him. And so afterwards, you know, on the break, we went and talked to him, and he said, "You guys sound great," and it was encouraging. He helped us get some other gigs, just so generous and encouraging to younger musicians. We were younger at the time. And he was wonderful. So this song that I want to use, or we're going to play, is Victor's Song. And it's just beautiful. Like Tom said, he was a Marine. But after he got out of you know, after Vietnam, it was when he was back from there, he became an activist. And he was all kinds of activities. But he started the Veterans for Peace in Minnesota. He was one of the founding members. And Jerry passed away just last fall. And so at his funeral, the Veterans for Peace were there. And instead of shooting the
21 guns, it's salute, 21 bells. Yeah.
They ring bells. Yeah. And that's what they did at his funeral. It was perfect. He was a peace-loving person, and this song really shows that side of him.
Another side of Jerry that I was always so impressed by is that guy could play out in the coldest weather imaginable. You know, and his fingers, he'd get through these songs. He was a street singer to his soul. I mean, he did a lot of concerts, but he loved playing on the streets for people. One of a kind guy. This is Jerry Rao with his song, Victor's Song.
My name is Freedom. I'm wild and reckless. I can't be stopped now. I'm like the wind. I know no boundaries. I can't be chained.
When I'm gone, will you sometimes sing my songs? Oh, will they pass on through like hard-working migrants who have done the job and then seem to vanish like the wind? They say vibrations never end once they're sent, and so I pray the words I write over the other eye. All these tools that I forge were gifted to me by and large. I gathered truth from the world and waved it like a flag unfurled. I stitched together words from the pictures that I heard. They say vibrations never end once they're sent, and so I pray the words I write over the other eye. I will miss you when I'm gone, for I love to sing you songs. If my words spoke to you, or some of they helped you through, please pass that tool along. That's the beauty of the song. They say vibrations never end once they're sent, and so I pray the words I write over the other eye. Spoke to you, or somehow they helped you through. Please pass that tool along. That's the beauty of the song. That's the duty of the song. Beauty of the song. Duty of the song.
Music that makes a difference on River City Folk. We heard two pieces of music there, beginning with Jerry Rao, the Victor's Song. And that was followed by The Beauty of the Song by my guests today, Curtis and Loretta. I'd like to say hello to all the folks who listen to River City Folk each week back in my old hometown of Omaha, Nebraska on KIOS FM, the voice of the Omaha Public Schools. Thanks very much for tuning into the show there this last, 30 years or so. Curtis and Loretta are here with me today from Minnesota, just north of the River City of Omaha, Nebraska. Of course, we're in the River City of Portland, Oregon today, here at Cafe Artichoke. Hey! The beauty of the song, that's what drives us on, Loretta. That's what keeps us going, is that feeling that is only duplicatable by the music within us. What was the inspiration for that particular song?
Well, I'll start. A lot of the songs we're playing today were just inspired by being home, you know, for a year and a half and contemplating, you know, what it is that it gave us time to grow. And in a lot of ways, there was positive aspects to this. And I think that's what a lot of these songs are about. But yeah, you wrote it.
I just feel so blessed to be able to play music and get whatever message you want out there. I just feel like, how did I get to be so lucky to do this?
And one of the lines is the duty of this song, too. Yeah. They're tools. They're tools. Songs are tools.
They are, and they stand on their own. They're not about personality or celebrity, despite what popular culture might tell us. The songs live on their own.
Yes.
If they deserve to live, they live on their own, and they reach out to us on their own.
I like that.
This is a song that I'm anxious to hear. I've only heard the title of it, but I'm reminded of playing at Godfrey Daniels in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, a number of times, and I'd go out and check out the town and walk along this massive old steel mill there. And this is called Bethlehem Steel Nights 1959 by a writer by the name of Tom Mank. How did you guys come across this song?
You know, they became friends of ours. We were playing at a place in Syracuse, New York, many years ago called Happy Endings.
Must have been two decades.
Yeah, some place people have played there. Yeah, and they were opening for us. So we got to be good friends with them. This wonderful couple, Tom Mank, who plays guitar and the songwriter, and his lovely wife, Sarah Smolin, who plays bowed cello. They play lovely music together. We've become really good friends with them over the years.
And this is proof that you don't have to play your styles and techniques, and you don't have to play the same kind of music at all to be greatly inspired by each other.
Yeah,
you know?
They really have a different style than us, but we love them. So he's the songwriter, and she plays beautiful bowed cello. She's classically trained, but she also teaches improv.
She's got a PhD in cello. These are wonderful people.
Yeah, so he wrote this song, Bethlehem Steel Nights, 1959, about being a child and going to the free night. His dad worked at the steel mills, but every so often they would open it up. All the steel workers could go and for free. And we were lucky enough we joined in on this CD. We both sang and Curtis played mandolin on this recording.
I think you'll love these guys. I doubt anybody in Portland's heard of them. They play in like Amsterdam and
the East Coast.
Known over there. Yeah. So yeah, listen to this song.
Lovely couple.
He's like a poet. You know, it's almost more like poetry and song.
It is.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, a lot of images. Beautiful images.
Bethlehem Steel Nights, 1959. God, I love that title. Tom Mank on River City Folk.
This American car holds us tight as we wind the streets toward the stadium lights. Out of the car.
Gotta clean out my karma closet, do good deeds for a deposit, throw out things I don't want to wear, old baggage piled up everywhere. I'm gonna have to say a prayer. In there, I got words hanging from a day when I met a car in the intersection. We were there at a four-way stop, but he took my turn, did not stop. All the words I used that day, they still make myself blush today. Gotta clean out my karma closet, do good deeds for a deposit, throw out things I don't want to wear, old baggage piled up everywhere. Say a prayer. Oh Lord, it's a mess in there. I can walk in where cobwebs still hide the things I wanted that were not mine. My friend got her a brand new car when she became a great big star, but it hardly felt jealous at all of Carnegie Hall would call. Gotta clean out my karma closet, do good deeds for a deposit, throw all things I won't wear, old baggage pile up everywhere. I'm gonna have to say a prayer. Oh Lord, it's a mess in there. Clean it out there, Curtis. Lots of guilt in that closet, the folks I should have called but did not. Late night binges and chocolate and the times I did not take a stand. And I forgot my dog outside in the rain the whole night one time.
I gotta clean out my karmic closet, do good deeds for a deposit, throw out things I wanna wear, old baggage piled up everywhere. Gonna have to say a prayer. Oh Lord, it's a mess in there.
But when I get things organized, sweep it out, let in some fresh air, walk the neighbor's dog a few times, and pay for someone else in line, well, polish up your shoes, or swear I'll pay all my dues.
Gotta clean out my karmic closet, do good deeds for a deposit, throw out things that I wanna wear, old baggage piled up everywhere. I'm gonna have to say a prayer. Oh Lord,
it's a mess in there. Gonna have to say a prayer. Oh Lord, it's messy in there.
We heard two pieces of music on River City Folk, beginning with Bethlehem Steel Nights 1959 by Tom Mank. They were, he and his partner were followed by my guests today on River City Folk, Curtis and Loretta from Minneapolis, Minnesota, with a song called Karmic Closet. I think we all have one of those closets that we wish was a little more tidy. So, nice tune there. So we heard the resonator guitar on that song, and we heard the mandocello earlier, two instruments rarely heard, but just a smattering of what you've got in your karmic instrument closet there at home, Curtis. You've been collecting instruments and repairing them and doing the folk version of horse trading there for decades now. Curtis buys these instruments and does whatever has to be done to get them into good shape and then trades them and moves along, whether they're D45 Martins or whether they're small ukuleles. But they all get another life, and then they get moved along unless he really likes it.
Yeah, you know, I mean, we kind of subsidized our musical endeavors for decades and decades, you know, and my love of musical instruments and my wallet, which was very, very, very small, and my love very, very large. So I had to learn to do repairs. That's the only way I could afford them. And then you have this beautiful option, actually, to, you know, sometimes sell them and make some money so you can keep playing music, and sometimes just to find homes for them, too. Sometimes you might even lose money on them, but you can't lose because they go to the right place, you know.
And she loves to do that too.
And she, I think you accuse me of being, I'm not quite as addicted as I used to be though.
No, he used to be much worse, and I can't complain.
She's actually the one that's starting to. I mean, with harps,
I have several harps.
Yeah, she has several.
All harp players do.
Several is a great word, you know.
Okay, seven. Okay.
I mean, our living room looks like a herd of buffalo. You know what I mean?
They lay on their backs down in the end of the living room. Seven. That's several. Seven. But you know, a couple are very small.
But Curtis, in the Midwest of the United States, Curtis Teague had a reputation for his horse trading of musical instruments. And we were talking before the program about some of the dogs that he has run across, very dogs with quite stellar lineages, which you might expect would sound fantastic, but it weren't necessarily so. We had a good time talking about that.
I will warn you. I have to say, I was very fortunate enough to pick up a couple of beautiful instruments right here at the Artichoke many years ago. But, just a word of wisdom to you. There's nothing worse than a really, really fancy guitar that doesn't sound any good. So beware of that. It's a very embarrassing thing to own, yeah. And I have had a couple, yeah. Fall in love with their looks and find out she's just not what you thought, yeah.
I could go down that path, but I don't. I think I'll keep my mouth shut at this point. You are listening to River City Folk. I'm your host, Tom May. We're going to hear a song right now by somebody who's meant so much to so many of us, and I always found her to be just a gracious, genuine, nice person. You know, there's all kinds of opinions out there in the musical world, but one thing that can't be argued is her enormous talent, and her enormous talent changed the world of acoustic music and still does. This is from her very, very first album, which was produced by David Crosby way back when. This is Joni Mitchell with her song For a Seagull. And what was it that made you choose this song, Loretta, as the song that one of the songs that has made such a big difference to you?
You know, Joni Mitchell was such an inspiration in my wanting to play folk music. First, it was Peter, Paul, and Mary, and I just loved them. And then in the 70s, I discovered Joni Mitchell and started listening to her. Just everything she did, her words, they're so poetic, and her music, her voice. She had everything. Plus, being a songwriter. And really back then, there weren't many women songwriters. And I was like, oh my gosh. You know, I think that happened with a lot of young women. It's like, wow, we could do that. And this song is just, the lyrics are so poetic. And the melody. I'm just totally in love with this song.
And then she came from just a little farther north.
Yes,
of Minnesota.
Yeah, so. They talk a lot like us.
From Canada, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Joni Mitchell on River City Folk with Song for a Seagull.
Fly, silly seabird, no dreams can possess you. No voices can blame you for sun on your wings.
Janie did it, don't blame me. I learned that when I was three. I wouldn't play, she called me quitter. Made me so mad I had to hit her. This happens every single time. They should arrest you for this crime. You buy a gallon of ice cream, and I eat it till my thighs could scream.
Without no one to blame but yourself.
Oh, you sure like to pin it on somebody else. There must be somebody I could sue. Somebody I could pass this buck. Na 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 na. He passed me going way too fast and cut me off, so I hit the gas. I stuck to him close as I could. He slowed down and smashed my hood. It's not my fault, don't look at me. What a stupid place to plant a tree. I just backed up, what can I say? It was standing right there in my way. When you got no one to blame but yourself. Oh, you'd sure like to pivot on somebody else. There must be somebody I could sue, or somebody I could pass this buck. Na 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 na. Now you do this to me all the time. Don't get your way and then you whine. So I get mad, don't talk for days. I'll show you, I'll make you pay. Why won't you just end this fight? Do it my way, do it right. You never listen to a word. I have to yell just to be heard.
When you got no one to blame but yourself.
Oh, you'd sure like to pin it on somebody else. There must be somebody I could sue. Somebody I could pass this buck. Na 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 na. Call my lawyer, life's not fair. Where's my success? Where's my share? I'm stuck down in this endless rut because no one will pick me up. The world's got it in for me. I burned myself in hot coffee. Lost my cash and Powerball. And how come you never call?
When you got no one to blame but yourself.
Oh, you'd sure like to pin it on somebody else. There must be somebody I could.
but soon somebody I could pass his buck. Na 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 na. Somebody I could pass his buck. Na 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 na.
We heard two pieces of music there on River City Folk. The beautiful song For a Seagull by Joni Mitchell. She was followed by my guests today, Curtis and Loretta from Minneapolis, Minnesota, with something a little bit more lighthearted. Somebody I Could Sue. So you got a little practice there for a sing-along that we're going to do right now. In the times that we live in, the news in the paper every day, it seemed like this was an appropriate song. So Curtis and Loretta and I sat down, and we're going to sing this together, and we hope that you'll join us. This song, which Pete Seeger put together with some words from the Bible, and a song that always resonates so very, very strongly. The Birds, of course, had a big hit with it, but Pete, kind of the progenitor of our profession, came up with the original idea for this song. So please sing it with us. This is Turn, Turn, Turn.
To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn, turn. And a time to every purpose under heaven.
A time to build up, a time to break down, a time to dance, a time to mourn, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together.
To everything, turn, 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 there is a season, turn, 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 and a time under heaven.
A time of love, a time of hate, a time of war, a time of peace, a time we may embrace, a time to refrain from embracing.
To everything, turn, 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 there is a season, turn, under heaven.
A time to gain, a time to lose, a time to rend, a time to sow, a time of love, a time of hate, a time for peace. I swear it's not too late.
To everything, turn, 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 there is a season, turn, turn, and a time to every purpose under heaven. And a time to every purpose under heaven.
Thank you so much for helping us out on that Birds, Pete Seeger Bible song, Turn, Turn, Turn. I'm your host, Tom May. You are listening to River City Folk live at Cafe Artichoke in the Rose City of Portland, Oregon on a Saturday afternoon. Thank you so much for joining us across the country. My guests have been Curtis and Loretta from Minneapolis, Minnesota. And we are all so happy in so many ways to be here to have weathered this difficult time that so many of us have gone through with this pandemic this last couple of years. So many musicians out on the roads now again, and gigs and venues starting to open up, as is true here at Artichoke in Portland. We are so thankful that you've joined us today. And Curtis and Loretta are going to give us one more song to take us out. What's this final song going to be?
A health to the company. We, you know, an old British Isles tune. We've been so inspired by these old British Isles tunes for so many years. A health to you all, indeed.
And a health to both of you. Curtis and Loretta on River City Folk.
Here's a health to the company and one to my lass. Let us drink and be merry all out of one glass. Let us drink and be merry, all grief to refrain. For we may all, might never all meet her again. Kind friends and companions, come join in my rhyme and lift up your voices in chorus with mine. Come drink and be merry, all grief to refrain, for we may all, might never all meet her again. So here's a health to the company and one to my lass. Let us drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let us drink and be merry, all grief to refrain, for we may all, might never all meet her again.
She's ready to sail. I wish her safe passage past doldrums and gales. And if e'er we should meet again on land or on sea, I will always remember your kindness to me.
So here's a health to the company and one to my lass. Let us drink and be merry all out of one glass. Let us drink and be merry, all grief to refrain, for we may all, might never all meet her again. Footsteps may falter, my wit, it might fail.
My course may be challenged by November gales.
Ere fortune shall prove to be friend or be foe, you will always be with me wherever I go. A health to you all, So here's a health to the company and one to my lass. Let us drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let us drink and be merry, all grief to refrain, for we may all, might never all meet her again.
Thank you.